Let's discuss another important section of this topic, that is volt-ampere characteristics of a PN junction. About PN junction, we already discussed that nature of a PN junction diode is unilateral. Unilateral implies we can write this is a term which is used for current flows only in one direction from P to N side. And if a current is supplied from N side to P side, it does not flow because of reverse biasing. We already discussed in previous sections. Now, in this section of volt-ampere characteristics, we can write that now we'll study the variation of current with voltage or with potential difference in both forward bias and reverse bias situation, and this is studied in two steps, that is for reverse biasing as well as for forward biasing, and these two steps are called the two volt-ampere characteristics of a PN junction diode. The first one we'll study is the forward bias characteristics, that is the variation of current with voltage when the PN junction diode is forward biased, and the second is reverse bias characteristics, that is the study of variation of current with potential difference when the PN junction is reverse biased. Let's study both of these simultaneously, and we plot a curve of a variation of current with the change in potential difference applied across a PN junction. On the next sheet, we'll continue. Let's plot the VI curve for PN junction diode. Here we can see that across this PN junction diode, we have applied the variable potential difference, and for measurement of its potential difference and current, we are also using a voltmeter and an ammeter. Now, when the key is closed and the voltage is increased, we can see initially the current flows in forward biasing when the electric field due to this external voltage exceeds the internal electric field of battery. So, initially the current is of quite low order, and at a point which is called VK, and say we are using a silicon diode, its VK is 0.7 volt, where the electric field exceeds the barrier potential, and afterwards when potential increases, current also increases. And this point afterwards, when the diode is said to be in forward biasing, and the electric field of external potential difference overcomes the internal electric field of the PN junction, the current flows. This is called knee point voltage, because the curve shape looks like bent of a knee, and that's why due to this bend it is called knee point voltage. And for different kind of semiconductors, the value of VK would be different. And this is called forward bias characteristics. And you can see this is not a linear graph, which is plotted by readings of voltmeter and ammeter, different readings of voltmeter and ammeter across the PN junction. And as this is not a straight line, we can see that the PN junction diode is a non-ohmic device. As we already studied, according to Ohm's law, the potential and current must be proportional to each other. So for ohmic devices, VI curve is always a straight line. As it is not a straight line, we can see that a PN junction is a non-ohmic device. And the variation of current with voltage follows a law which is beyond the scope of our lectures, but just I'm giving you the expression. a variation of current is given by I naught e to power EV by KT minus 1, where here I naught is called reverse saturation current and V is the applied voltage, K is the Boltzmann constant and T is the temperature of the PN junction in thermal equilibrium, and this is the current which we are plotting here. And in this situation we can say for high values of voltages, here e to power EV by KT will be very large compared to unity. So the value of current can be given as I naught e to power EV by KT. This appears as an exponential curve for high values of voltages. And if we say, if we reverse the battery, we connect a negative terminal of battery on the P side and positive on the N side of PN junction, this junction will be reverse biased and the value of current will be very low, that is due to minority charge carriers. So in this situation here, if an opposite side, negative side, in reverse biasing, if we increase the voltage, a very small value of current flows which almost remain constant and the value is equal to reverse saturation current, that is I naught, and it goes on up to a specific voltage VZ, at which suddenly current increases to very high values, or we can say this is the voltage when the electric field across the junction which is supporting the internal electric field. As dear students, you can recall that in reverse biasing, the external electric field or electric field due to external potential difference is in the same direction of internal electric field. So it increases, and VZ is a voltage in reverse biasing zone when this electric field reaches at so high values that it will start extracting electrons from valence band of semiconductor and depletion layer, and excessive electron hole pair generation starts due to the electric field by the reverse biased voltage. And due to generation of excessive electron hole pairs, excessive current flows in the circuit. But up to this level, this current I naught is only due to minority carriers. So this curve which I have drawn for the negative voltage is called reverse bias characteristic, or this is called reverse biasing zone, and the curve which is plotted for the positive voltage is called forward biasing zone or forward bias characteristic for a PN junction. Here the point where excessive electron hole pair generation takes place, that is the voltage VZ, this is called breakdown voltage, and sudden generation of this electron hole pairs and depletion layer is called breakdown of PN junction. Afterwards, excessive current flows, and in normal situations, in realistic cases, we can say the current produces such an amount of heat because of which the junction also melt and P part and N part get separated from each other. And this voltage, once again I would say you must keep in mind, is called breakdown voltage, and it is also called a zener voltage, because in later section of this topic we'll study the formation of zener diodes which are specifically made to operate in breakdown region. So we'll discuss in later section about this breakdown in more details.